finally some vacation. Now I'm going to sit down and enjoy some Sherlock Holmes. Ooh, the science of deduction. That is some logic shit.
There were such steps, however. The train of reasoning ran. Here is a gentleman of medical type, but with the air of a military man. Clearly an army doctor, then.
That is not a deductive argument. That calls for an episode.
The first fully systematized logical system is usually credited to Aristotle. And the most important part about his system is probably his syllogisms. What is a syllogism? Glad you asked. An Aristotelian syllogism is commonly made up of two premises and one conclusion. The classical example is that all men are mortal, Socrates is a man, therefore Socrates is mortal.
This argument is not just an Aristotelian syllogism, but a valid deductive argument. The thing about deductive arguments is that if both the premises are true, then the conclusion must necessarily be true as well, right? There is no way for the conclusion to be false if both the premises are true.
So let's get back to Sherlock Holmes then, shall we? Here's an example. Here is a gentleman of medical type, premise one. But with the air of a military man, premise two. Conclusion, clearly an army doctor. But does these two premises necessarily make the conclusion true? No, it clearly doesn't. So if Sherlock Holmes didn't use deductive reasoning, what did he use? Glad you asked. In matter of fact, Sherlock Holmes utilizes abduction. Yep, that's the name of it. I know it's an odd name, but hear me out.
Abductive reasoning is usually credited to the American philosopher and logician Charles Saunders Peirce, and it is sometimes referred to as inference to the best explanation. The easiest way to explain it is, of course, through a crime case. Let's say that Sherlock has found a dead man hanging from a rope in a room with no windows that was locked from the inside. This man has hanged himself. This is most likely correct, for it is an inference to the best explanation. But here is the crux of it all. All the premises of the case does not necessarily make the conclusion true. It is the best explanation, but not the only one. There could be an alien who teleported himself into the room, hanged the man, and then teleported himself out.
Highly, highly implausible, I admit, but there is a chance. So the important difference between deduction and abduction is the necessity of the conclusion. And I would actually say that abduction is actually probably the most common logical inference there is. We use it all the time without thinking about it.
Oh no, the store is out of ice cream. Probably because someone else bought the last box, and not because of an ice cream monster who stole it.
Oh, there's some cobweb. Spider-Man must be close. Or maybe just an ordinary spider? I think you catch my drift, right?
So there you have it. You cannot argue against the logic of Aristotle. Sorry, Sherlock, you lose. Thank you so much for watching. Take care until the next one.